Welcome back to North Dakota today as we're continuing to be at the Red River Valley Fair. And one of the biggest things to talk about here is agriculture. It's actually one of North Dakota's biggest industries.
Right. And today we have Tristan Hardin joining us to tell us a little bit more about,
The Ag Education Center.
Ag Education Center.
Yep. So this is the Ag Education Center. So the center is to bring kids and their families out here to learn the importance of ag education. It's an impact on everybody's daily life, whether it's the food you eat or the products you're using. So we try to have hands-on things here that can kind of describe each and every one of those things, whether it's the crops or the livestock.
And I love that. I love like the hands-on
yes.
part.
Yeah.
Where people can learn and actually like
I think that's how
understand.
Kids I think that's how kids learn best. So
yes.
If I can make an impact here with that, I'm doing my job.
Yeah. So what can people learn in here then?
So you can learn how they produce the crops. We actually have it so they can get the byproduct of each crop and livestock product. And so they can go around, they can look at the animals, they can look at the crop stations, and they can get a feel for agriculture.
I definitely like that. And also, I got a chance to come in here yesterday. You have some animals in here as well.
Yes.
What are some of those animals people can check out?
There's ducks, sheep, turkeys, there's a dairy calf, there's a beef calf, and a big hit is the piglets that are in here. So, if you can, come check them out for sure.
So are they little piglets and just born?
Yep, they were just born about a week and a half ago.
Wow.
So, yeah.
I think when I was here last time, what was it? A pig could have 8 to 10?
Yeah,
piglets?
They can have quite a few piglets. So it's fun to see, and they're cute to look at as well.
And they are cute to look at.
Yeah, they're adorable. It's and then they get real big.
Yes.
I also saw how you can name the cow in here too.
Really?
I saw Tessie and Tinker were some of the names.
Yep, Tessie, Tilly, and Tootsie. So
okay.
Yep.
So the kids can name the cow.
Yeah, exactly. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I was corny and I was like, I'd name it Calvin because has cow in it.
Yeah.
But they didn't bring me in there, so Tinker works best for me.
We're looking for a T name, so if you have any other
clever
ideas,
yeah,
let me know.
But really, this is for all family.
Yes,
all
everybody
ages to learn.
I want everybody to walk through here and learn something about agriculture and why it's important to the everyday life.
Right. I think it's neat. Just right outside our back door.
That's right.
Literally,
yeah.
We can drive and see crops.
Exactly.
And so for adults and kids to all understand, this is where your food comes from.
Exactly. And all the byproducts as well. I don't think people realize how many byproducts and all of our clothes and everything we eat, everything has to pertain to agriculture.
So when it comes to the ag, I know when I was talking to Brandon on Friday, he was saying that people aren't learning it as much as they need to be nowadays. I guess, why is it important to bring that forgotten lesson back?
Like I said, you use agriculture in everything you do, and I don't think people realize that. So my goal, like I said before, is to bring hands-on activities because people learn better with hands-on activities. And if somebody's telling them about it, a lot of people don't even step foot on a farm hardly anymore. So having the fair and being able to bring that to people that live in the city or that don't have the chance to go out to a farm, I think it's super important for them to learn everyday life about livestock and crops and agriculture and all of the things that go together with that.
The whole process. Yes,
yeah.
Definitely
works
important.
Together.
I definitely like that.
Yeah.
I guess, what is your favorite part about ag? What do you like?
I actually grew up raising livestock, so it wasn't so much the crop part of things, but even since I started my job, I've learned more about the crops because, animals eat the crops as well. The corn, oats, soybeans, it all kind of goes together. So even the crops that we're eating, the animals are eating as well.
Definitely
right.
learn.
Yeah,
that.
And I think sometimes we forget all of those things too.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
Just like you said, you were part of the livestock, but not crops, but you really were part of crops.
Exactly. Exactly. So, yep, the livestock is my favorite part. I grew up raising livestock at Clay County in Barnesville, actually. And then I've actually traveled nationally to other livestock shows as well. So my favorite part is the livestock, but every bit of agriculture is just as important as the other.
I'm like
a big
that.
Soybean fan.
Ooh,
I
are
like
you?
Like edamame, So I don't know. It would be great for me to experience I want to go to the soybean station
no,
and learn
smart.
All about it.
I like
right.
that. Learn something new and learn how it works. And
yeah.
it's important to learn that.
That's right. That's right.
Definitely.
And that all of these are in so many products.
Right.
Yes. Yes. Definitely. Oh, I love that. Definitely make sure you come out here and enjoy the different Ag Center, and we'll continue to be out here for North Dakota today. I'll keep continuing to tune in.